Hello everyone, you are watching Dorukhan. My kill pack has just been replenished and I have a daily mission of playing Watch Captain Artemis. On top of that, with destroy enemy cards and reuse of ranged attacks, I have thought that trying out the new Death Watch tribal deck for this the Ravenwing mission is a good time right now, and also one campaign energy has been charged. I should play that as soon as possible after the opening of kill pack. My space marines have been reduced to 1153. They were around 2100 ish points, and in fact let me show you my space marine deck. I have used Artemis. This deck I have used 3 Psykers, Niall and Tigris were both level 2. Thanks to the RNG, I have received their last copies for being level 3. Their power level has been quite increased. As you can see, 3 really strong and capable Psykers, even more have their powers increased. Now my Terminator has its shield in tier 2. This was the deck. However, right now I will quickly remove all of them and show you a full Dark Angels deck. Just like we are going to use 2 days later in the campaign. Of course, once again, this is optional. You are not forced to do this. I simply love this because it appears to have synergized. I mean, they appear to be in more synergy with one another. How to put, they feel nice. Let's say a full Ultramarine deck, a full Imperial Fist deck. I just love including cards of a single chapter. In fact, playing Space Marines in that way makes my experience more fun. You may share or not share this idea of mine, this preference of mine. Yes, this is the ranged one, because they don't really glow right now. It's quite hard to make up which one is which. So let's quickly upgrade the core ones. He's fast. I will use Midael for both first part and the second part of the campaign. He is both a Dark Angel and a fast unit. You can differentiate fast units in Space Marines. They have either these jetpacks, Brother Midael here has his, or has some kind of mounts, like either a wolf or a bike. You can differentiate them. Let's unlock these two common traits. They were all level 2. They want only 10 gold. Yes, our taunt has been unlocked. Precision shot, it's quite important because I believe it will hit around 40%. Around 10, I think it will hit, and also barrage. This will give them quick power, little power spikes to these cards. And yes, I believe I can't afford these upgrades. However, let's go and see if this full Dark Angel deck is any viable or not. Right now we are in the 1153 trophies. We are playing for Space Marines with Artemis. Artemis is a Death Watch member. Regardless, 8 Dark Angels units. In recent previous campaigns, I have actually seen these that share a keyword with them. These cards, sometimes they actually synergized well with one another. So let's see and find out. It's actually a 50-50. They may or they might have, obviously. Let's put our precision unit Hellblaster on the left to pop up their shield. They will most likely go with a ranged attack, as Bedrock tends to do. Okay, they have the initiative. Let's put down our taunt units. Yes. I don't think it can survive right now, but with 20%, perhaps. Only one way to find out. They're only, I believe, yeah, the first shield, only shield is popped up. Yeah, unfortunately, they will be able to take down our card. They don't have the classic Bedrock cards, unfortunately. The 60% of our attack, meaning around more than 25-ish, only 20 will left, and with the 18, I think we will take down the Death Copter on the right, thanks to Zachary, Master Lazarus, and also 28 attack on the left lane, which is quite nice. I don't really like... Yeah, why do we need to go... yeah, let's go melee, it's far more better in fact. I don't even think deploying Lazarus on the right was a good idea, regardless. Yep, the Snazmek and Smashagun, none of them will be able to take down our cards, I would say. Yeah, only 1 HP, Midael, yeah, that last upgrade really did its job. Quite nice. Also, yeah, and we actually hit the plus 1 of its only remaining HP. Unfortunately, once again, Hellblaster don't have much melee attack. That's quite sad. However, I will take down that bubble checker, right? Exactly. With a precision shot or a furious charge, I will take down that card real soon. Yeah, they will go for a double wipe. And yeah, I think the Master Lazarus unfortunately falls as well. Quite sad to see. Okay, let's see. Let's put Brother Zakaria on the right. Yes, Nazmek falls down. Quite nice to see. Let's go full melee. In fact, Interrogator Chaplain goes on the... Not on the middle. Let's put him on the left. As the Blaster Jet will go to the left in a couple of minutes. And in fact, let's go put Broken Knife as a sacrificial piece. Or in fact, the Jet Fighter will go to left and will focus on our Terminator. Yeah, putting these in this order makes more sense. Another 33, lovely. And let's see if our combined triple force is enough, and 104 is enough. It's actually not too easy, not too challenging. And now the Bedrock is all left alone. Perhaps with the upgraded cards, this deck has some viability. Around, I can see this deck rising up to 1500s. Yes, this deck can go to 1500s quite easy. You can alternate between, for instance, the Bedrock at ranged, so we couldn't play ranged much. However, you see, quite a nice melee. All the power levels of commons, rares, epics and legendaries have been increased with the new traits. So watch out for new viable decks and previous viable decks being a little bit less viable, perhaps. Yeah, our Chaplain falls, and he was only level 2, yet stood out quite nicely. Let's put that blow unit at the core of the danger. Regardless, they have... And Artemis for the takes the cake. 75, just a clean number of trophies. 5 exact skulls and the skull of the Bedrock to, on top of that. It's quite a nice match. Yeah, I'm quite happy with the results. So, a full Dark Angels deck has potential, as you can see. And of course, every victory against Bedrock is counts as 2 victories, in my opinion. So, that's another bonus. Thank you for watching me. Making this video make me quite happy. If you have a specific Space Marine chapter ideas for me to make or yours alone, feel free to share it down below. Take care of yourselves.